Welcome to Srinu Technologies. So in the earlier slide we discussed about Gradle and their importance. Next, why we need to learn the Gradle? Is there already tools which is Ant and Maven is there? So now let us start with how to install the Gradle related software. So whenever you are going to install Gradle related software, first, make sure that Gradle is going to work with Groovy language. So, underlying that Groovy language is also called as JVM based language. We require to install Java related software. So, Java related software means what? Normal our JDK should be there. So, what first we need to do means, please ensure that you must and should have the Java related software. This Java related software, which version we need to use? That is also one of the question. So here, what we need to be understand here is, whenever you want to install that Gradle related thing, first make sure that you have one site called Gradle.org site. In this site, you have the downloading. So here we need to be understand that which JDK version we need to be use. Now see here. Now the latest version of the Gradle, now they are going to use is, now the latest one is 4.4. So for this 4.4 release, what is required here is, they are going to giving what, which JDK is much more compatible, means they are telling like JDK and JRE version 7 or higher than, means it's 8. So first make sure that which version of Java here we are going to use. Check first with that. So just open the command prompt, then type Java hyphen version. So now here the Java version is what? 1.8. So now Java related software, it's okay. So next, we need to go for what? Installing JDK. So installing the JDK, here what I specified here is, I specified the steps. The first step is what? Download the Gradle software from the respective site. Here this is the what the site. And unzip that one. Then, and also, we need to create one environmental variable, Gradle home, and we need to give up to Gradle root path. Next, we need to be add that bin related thing to the path. So these are the steps we need to be follow. And also next last step is what? We need to verify that whether the Gradle is successfully installed or not. So this is the last command. So we will go through like each and everything here. First we will start with downloading that one. Where I can able to download this one means, you have the Gradle.org. Here you can have the different types of things is there. Now here binary version, and you have what? One more is what? Complete version. So if you go with the binary versions, only the Gradle related things like software, like important whatever the thing, bin related libraries is going to get available. But sometimes I want to get the entire source code and the documentation related to the Gradle. Like whenever we need to go with I want to learn the more things, the documentation, what it is going to get provided. So you can better to go with complete related thing. Size, relatively the size of binary version to this complete version is more because of all the things is included here. So next, what is this means? Like they are giving one more kind of recommendations to you. If you go to the binary version means it does not containing any docs. If you want anything docs, you can able to get from where? Online retailer. So they are giving the different type of what? Online resources. So first of all, what I did means I downloaded this binary related here. So just I will go with what? Binary only. So in the binary related, and you can go with the complete related. Just we can go for the comparison. So I did the both downloads here. So it is get downloading here. Now, both the things. So earlier it is 1.4.3 is there. Now I think it is going get now and also now. So this is what. So let us explore inside that what we are going to have here. Now comparing to the first one, go with unzip this, and next we are going with 1.4.4 related na. So then we have that. This is also go for unzip. So you have both the things is there. So one is all version is available here, and then parallelly what I have. Bin version. Sorry, I think this is 1.4. You can go with latest one. So these are things. So by seeing these two things, you can get the more cut of more comparison related to this one. What is going to get provided here? So when we are going to have that important related what related to our Gradle, it is getting from what like bin folder, initd, and we have library folder and media folder. So these are the folders what we going to have to use primary, like these are the major things for the Gradle related. So these are the things. Coming to this one, like we have the docs folder and we have some samples and also source code. When you open this source code, we have the different kind of what packages again available here. In this you are going to see the lot of codes. Most of these codes, they have been written in case of what? Groovy language and also Java related. Means now we will go inside that and we can see this now. And also what? We have docs. So user guide what we need to have to use, and you can go inside that and you can able to get that all the things. Most of the times we have some index.jsp will be there, or we have here. So this is what the user guide. So just click that to open this user guide and you will get the complete documentation of that what the user guide. So you can get here and you can able to get practice what is the requirement for you, then you can able to get entire things here. So this is what differences you can get from the two flavors. One is the binary flavor, another one means here from binary flavor and also from complete. So and also you can get more kind of examples also. If you want to do practice, then you have the more kind of examples is. So this examples also, it will be helpful for our application development. Like whenever I want to go with, most of the times we are working with Java. So Java related, if I want to go with examples, what I can do, just I can go with the example and can see that what is the content they are going to get provided here. So like that, we have so many kind of advantages when you go with what? The version with what all. Means this is a complete version coming to this one. Now, anyway, like the primary things, whatever it is required here, we are going to fulfilling our requirement. So that's why I am going to continue with what? The version called what? This one. Binary version. So I will take just, I will take this path. Then, so the first one, coming to the slides, what I given. So first one downloaded the content, then I need to unzip that. So I done that unzip related here. So second part is also done here. Then third one is what? We need to create a Gradle underscore home in the environmental related. So like just like the Java, how you are going to do that environmental related part, the same thing you can follow. So right click with this, then we can go for the properties, advanced system settings, then you have the environmental related variables, create new. So what is the name here I want to use? Gradle underscore home. So just I can give that Gradle underscore home here, then paste. Then next is what we need to give the Gradle related path. So I will go with what? Gradle, this one. Now paste. So just open, sorry, okay. Then next what we need to add, the same kind of path to bin. So what I need to do, select the path. Whenever we select the path, it is already having the data here. So don't disturb the entire data, whatever which is already having. So next what I need to do, I want to go with what? inside the bin, then this is the completely, like this is the Gradle batch file I want available for entire my system. So what I need to do, just I can give the copy paste here, then it's okay. So just last I added this one, okay. So just to close that one and also close. Now what we did, we completed with this four kind of steps. So let us see that whether it is successfully installed or not. So what is the command here? So Gradle underscore v, and either you can use what, Gradle underscore version. So what we need to do, just you can open the command prompt. So when we open this command prompt here, what is that be there, give the command. So Gradle space hyphen v. So now which version we installed? So this is the Gradle version, Gradle 4.4 we are using. And also what is the another same command, what is that, this is a shorthand notation, or you can go for what, you can write the complete thing, it is also work. So Gradle hyphen hyphen version, same thing here, there is no vary. But here the interesting thing what you need to be understand means, this is the what interesting thing you need to be understand. If you see here, we already discussed that Gradle is built on top of what, Groovy based thing. So you need to think like, if you want to run any Gradle related things, you want Gradle related software is required. So Gradle is going to comes with inbuilt Groovy software also. So the Groovy software internally, it is using 2.4.4, means it is already out of box feature for what, Gradle itself. And also it is going to use, means actually the Groovy is the combination of Ant and Maven. So underlying Ant is going, Ant is Ant related, whatever the things is also using here is what, 1.9.9. And also the JDK, what it is using, it is using the 1.8 related thing. So what present whatever our JDK installed. Next is what, our operating system. What is an operating system? So the operating system present we are using what, Windows 7. So based upon that we can get into conclusion like what, to run any Gradle related things internally they are going to use Groovy and Ant. So to run any Gradle, means to run any Gradle related things, you want Groovy but you don't want to install that one, it is coming with inbuilt kind of thing. So it is well managed kind of thing, means we don't want to spare any extra more kind of time here to go with installation. Just you can go with Gradle, automatically it is bundled with all the things. So that's why we installed just now what, Gradle related software into our machines. So after completing that, then you can able, like this is the only what first way we are going to use. We have different kind of ways is also there to go with installation based upon the, like this is what manually we can go with installation with pack manager, means SDK related installation, and you can go with Brew and Scoop, and we have different kind of whatever the support is also there. Depend upon the operating systems it will be going to get supported, but this version is recommended. Why? Means this can be a portable kind of thing. Here we don't want to require anything installation steps, just we can go for drag and drop. Suppose some people they are going to use this Linux or anything like macOS, so for that also you can go with what, the same kind of steps, but here the only what will going to get means the command will be changed. Makedir for what, like you want to create one directory and you need to have the Gradle there, and unzip that one into what, unzip command hyphen d, it is going to unzip that one into there. Then you will get ls, means the list of what Gradle related what you want to use, and you will get the complete information. Like this is ls is going to give list of whatever the available things. Now just you can use this export related path into where, in your Linux systems. Normally we are using Windows now, that's why we are going to go with what, my computer and environmental things. Then if you are working with any micro this Linux related OS, you can better to go with what, this kind of command. So ultimately the last whatever you are going to use, this is the same thing we can use. And one more way is what, we have one more way is with the Gradle wrapper. We have this one of the concept, like we can able to go with Gradle wrapper also. But now we are not going to discuss this Gradle wrapper related installation. We can discuss what? Next, in the future videos, we will discuss more elaborate on Gradle wrapper. Here, the Gradle wrapper is one of the best, like we can say it is one of the good kind of what feature we can able to get from Gradle. This is not we can able to find in Ant and Maven also. So we can discuss this, like next we will going to discuss with what? Build related, like we are going to write that build related, build.gradle related things in the next video with more details. Okay, thank you.
Hope you have understood. Keep watching our videos. Keep learning.